this either side has come to a goal. It's too far for Hendry. Thank you very much, says Gunn. To Little, can they profit from this? He'll feed Hendry in. Great chance for John Hendry. Blasted wide, should have scored. He's only got the one goal since he's moved from Middlesbrough. He's not registered here at Oakwell. He should have been celebrating then.
Well, this is an excellent chance. Little wins the ball back. He gets his head up. He plays the ball in for Hendry, who's free. And really, Hendry's got to score here. We've seen him do it many times before, but that's a bad miss.
Now Daryl Sutchin, he's got some pace. Did the right thing, checked inside the marker. Norwich have a lot of bodies forward here. Fleck feeds a good ball in. Adams onside. Watson makes the save, a critical 1-2. And chances at both ends suddenly appearing. And Adams, with 8 goals already this season, could well have been up to number 9 there.
Again, Adams was in a great position, and really he'd be disappointed he hasn't scored there, as was Hendry previously.
Well, we'll see that in a moment, and I'm sure Dave Watson will be happy to see it again. It was a very good save. Now Milligan for Norwich. Loses it, but it's picked up again by Fleck. And a fresh air shot from him, and then he drags Sheridan down. So that gives us a chance to look at this one.
This was a good ball by Fleck. He picked Adams out, who was free. He strikes the ball, and he'll be disappointed, but it was a good save by Watson also, who knocked it away, and for Barnsley, they were able to clear their lines.
Sure, the game would be so much different if they could get a goal before the break. Henry's got the chance. Gunn comes from his line, and he will make the save. And it's just not running in the final quarter of the field for Barnsley.
Well, in that instance, Henry's first touch was poor, and that's let him down, because this is good play. He's got, done everything right, and as you can see, his first touch is too long, and that gives Gunn a chance to get out there.
Straight away to the other end, and Robert Fleck could finish this for Norwich, and Watson stands up to make the save. Johnson powers on into the area. He'll cut it across here. Chances for Norwich. And with the ball bobbling around all over the place, it ends up in the hands of Watson, and that really sums up the way this game is going. So exciting, exhilarating, and it looks as though we're going to get a goal, and then we never do.
Yeah, this is end-to-end stuff. A Fleck attacks the box, he gets a shot, and Watson gets a good block, and this is good follow-up play by Johnson and composure. He clips it across, and fortunately for Barnsley, they're able to get that away and clear.
Straight to the other end, and this is Redfern. He's stronger on the right foot than the left, and he eventually managed to manoeuvre it onto the right foot and put it wide.
One can see here Redfern plays a good little give and go, and he's pushed himself wide, and really he should have gone his left, but he wants to come back on his favoured right, and it's good defending by Norwich to get the blocking.
Johnson knows Adams is wide, tries to get inside the fullback, and it might spin away even now for Adams, and again it comes off him, and he nearly profited from that. It would have been a rather fortunate goal, to say the least. But to his credit, he kept battling away to get into position. And now the longer effort is from Crook. That would have been audacious if he'd scored from there, all 35 yards.
Yeah, that was a little bit of a let-off for Barnsley there. Norwich got one or two bobbles that went for them here. The ball's played inside the fullback there. Adams gets on, the first tackle, bobbles away, and it should have really been dealt with by Athelby. And it rebounds to Adams, who can't quite get onto it.
And we've not got a goal here at Oakwell in the first 45 minutes. It's been enterprising, it's been entertaining. Chances missed at both ends, especially by Wilkinson in the first minute for Barnsley. But that's the way it's gone. And at half-time, it's Barnsley 0, Norwich City 0. We'll be back after the break. Oakwell, fingers crossed that we get a goal in this half. It's been the sort of game that's really deserved one. But it's still 0-0 as Norwich get us underway again. And there are no substitutions, I can tell you, so both Mike Walker and Danny Wilson obviously happy enough that these men can do the job. Well, I think the crowd were royally entertained in the first half, and they'd love to see some goals on a cold, sharp South Yorkshire night. So it's 0-0, but Johnson has played it straight into the path of John Hendry. peculiar one that, and Hendry will go on and slips the ball through, but it came off the side of a Norwich boot, I think it was Rob Newman's, and straight back to Gunn. The ball through the middle is a dangerous one, the little back header opens things up for Robert Fleck. Edie's in the middle too, Adams is calling for it wider, he'll knock this one through, Adams intelligently stayed onside, and that's an excellent challenge.
Again, Norwich showed how good they are on the counter-attack when you're attacking. They break very quickly, they play the ball forward and positively, and that was a good instance here, where Fleck's got himself in a good position. He picks out Adams, and Adams' first touch is a bit disappointing here. It's too far away, and it allows the Barnsley player to get a challenger.
The cross looks dangerous. Drawn out of the air by Watson. I certainly think that interception by Dazoo was a vital one, and he's a contender for man of the match, I would have thought, tonight.
Well, it was certainly a good challenge, but Adams will be disappointed with his first touch in that instance.
Still 0-0. Barnsley in possession. Redfern slips it out wide for Eden. Liddle again makes the run, and the ball holds up for him on the turf. And he'll look to at least get a corner out of this. He might get a free kick out of it. Rob Newman goes over to say something to the linesman. What a daft position again to give away a free kick.
A ridiculous position. I mean, Liddle's going actually nowhere, and he's just got to keep his cool, keep him there, and he's pushed him, and it's a dangerous position to have a free kick against.
Well, Dazoo scored in the last two matches, and he was calling for it in there. Comes back towards Hendry, who gets his head to the ball, and here's the shot! And what a cracking goal as well! And Barnsley have the lead.
Well, Norwich will pay the price of giving the free kick away out there in an unnecessary position. The delivery comes in here from Sheridan. It's got away well by Danny Mills. A little bit of luck here. The ball goes back in, and young Moses slings his right foot, and it's a cracking goal. You know, you can't stop those. Gunn will have no chance of that. It's one of those situations where we can see Norwich clear the ball. It gets to the edge. Hendry just really heads that back in. He doesn't really know where it's going. Moses is left, and he cracks a fine goal in. Any striker would be proud of that one.
Yeah, you took the words out of my mouth there. Adrian Moses has only ever got one goal, and that was back in April against Wolverhampton Wanderers. He wouldn't have played tonight if Steve Davies had been fit. But that is a cracker of a shot from a young defender with the best moment of his young career. In the way there, much to Edie's consternation. Liddle, it's a bristling contest at the moment, and here is Liddle. It's cut out by Newman, nearly went back to Liddle. Now Edie, as opposed to Eden on the other side. To be fair to Barnsley, they've covered Darren Edie very well tonight, but now it's Such. Fleck's making the run outside of him, a good dummy as well, good decoy running made there, Robert Fleck.
It's certainly been an entertaining game, John. You know, both teams have contributed very well. Overall, Barnsley just probably deserve to be in front due to the chances they've had. But certainly there's a while to go, and one wouldn't write Norwich off.
No Fleck there is short of goals at the moment this season. He's still got a couple. He's always dangerous. Straight up in the air from Sheridan. And out by Jones. And again by Jones. One of the youngsters in this Barnsley side. He's only 21. He's done well again tonight. There he is.
Yes, young lad has been given his chance, and he's grabbed it. And, you know, he's coming to a side that's playing well, and that'll be good for him. It'll be interesting to see, John, whether, you know, Mike Walker decides to bring on Keith Scott at centre-forward just to give him another attacking option and perhaps switch to a 4-4-2 system.
Yeah, that's a lot aimed at Liddle. Second favourite to get the ball though. Such turns away from trouble. Gives it to Newman, who could have joined Bristol City at the start of this season. He could have gone back there to his old club in unison with Joe Jordan, but he chose to stay at Norwich and sign a new contract. Oh, it's well won by Liddle. Hendry just knocks it back into the path of Redfern, who'll go on and slip it in here for Wilkinson. Chances here for Hendry to make it two, and the keeper stopped. Wilkinson follows in. Barnsley lead by 2 goals to nil, and the barren run is over. And you've got to feel pleased for Paul Wilkinson, who's had one of the longest spells of his career without a goal. It's his first in 12 matches. He's poked it into the back of the Norwich net, and Barnsley lead 2-0 now.
There was good movement here when Redfern played the ball through to Wilkinson. Wilkinson did a reverse ball to Hendry, and really one fancies that Hendry should have scored there, but Wilkinson's following up well, and he toe-ends it into the goal. I think the Norwich players are claiming there's an offside here, but I don't think that is the case. I think they might be saying that Hendry might be, but the linesman was perfectly placed. And we see Hendry gets the ball, it's blocked, and Wilkinson gets a little bit of luck there to toe in that in.
And he needed a bit of luck, Paul Wilkinson.
Often that happens, John. Like, he had the great opportunity early on to score, which is an easier chance than that. But he's done well, he's got his boot to it. But it'd just be an interesting factor whether, in actual fact, Hendry was offside on that ball play through.
From Norwich. Free kick. Oh, and trouble here with Andy Johnson. And a real free-for-all now, just what the referee didn't want.
Well, the referee didn't ask for it, did he? It's, I think Johnson's gone in late there. That was the first impression. A little bit of frustration creeping in, and everybody's piled in, and it makes it difficult for the referee when that happens.
Well, Andy Johnson, a young player who was sent off in successive matches last season, he's been on better behaviour since then, but he's certainly going to get a yellow card from Mr. Franklin. The other players always infuriate people by wanting to get involved. They're told to go away in no uncertain terms.
Yes, you know, I think there's pure frustration there because they're behind, but that's not going to get you anywhere. It kills the game, and you can either end up with a booking or a sending off in these instances. The referee's decided that caution in this instance.
Well, let's have another look at the goal here.
There we see, it's very tight as he plays it. But if you're playing offside in those instances, you can get punished. It's dodgy play, but again, Wilkinson gets that little bit of good fortune to stick it in.
Edie has taken over Brooks' role in midfield. Norwich with a passing game again, string it together. Clever dummy, almost two there, but didn't get Edie through. Barnsley will be very content with this situation at the moment. Sheridan, it opened up for him there. Milligan sort of went away from him. So it's out wide with Wilkinson. Redfern goes round in circles to get away from Forbes, pinches it through, takes it back, hits the shot, and it comes back off the ankles of the defender. He did. On across, but it does reach Hendry. It shouldn't have done, really. Hendry can attack from here. Hits the shot. Goal number three. Cracker, John Hendry. And the crowd are loving this. They are roaring at the moment. Barnsley are roaring as well. And John Hendry gets his first goal at Oakwell since his move from Middlesbrough. Barnsley 3, Norwich City 0.
A little bit of luck attached to this because Sutch should have really cleared that instead of trying to control it. Hendry picks it up and does well, takes it to the left and strikes a firm and excellent finish. That's a fine finish there. As we see, the ball comes in here. Sutch really should have been a defender and cleared that. And it set it up for Hendry to take him on. He gets it on his right foot, pulls it wide, and it's a good fines finish that gives Gunn no chance.
And it should be game, set and match for Barnsley now. Interestingly, both John Hendry and Paul Wilkinson scored against Norwich for Middlesbrough a couple of seasons ago. In a 3-3 draw, but tonight it's 3-0. Barnsley very much in the driving seat, though Norwich have a corner. But there's still a good quarter of an hour left.
Well, they've got a lot of work to do now, Norwich, to get back into this game.
Well, they've got a corner to start that off. Looks straight up in the air. Well, I know, Dave, you and I saw a game last Friday night, which ended 3-3 after one side had been 3 in front at Huddersfield.
Yeah, there was a lot longer to go then, John, at that stage.
There was. But it has been known to happen, so don't write Norwich off yet, as Polston goes up for the header, and the ball is all over the place. They've got one. I told you they might. It's Rob Newman. A little flick in from no more than 3 or 4 feet out. And Rob Newman, with his first of the season, gets Norwich on the score sheet, and they're coming back into it.
This is again from the second corner that's come in. there's people challenging there, and in actual fact Polston goes up with two, and there's a little bit of a clash between Watson and Sheridan getting muddled up there, and it's a drop to Noonan in the box. We see the opportunity here, there's a challenge where the keeper comes, there's Fleck as well, it drops out and Johnson plays a ball in, and Rob Newman's on hand just to put that away.